Should I update to Windows 11? May 2025 update. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is a revision of my article and video on whether or not you want to update to Windows 11. As the countdown gets closer, my answer is shifting. Up until now, there really hasn't been a compelling need to upgrade. And honestly, while that hasn't really changed with October 2025 getting closer and closer, it's time to more seriously consider whether or not you really want to. Now, before anyone takes this the wrong way, I am in no way saying you must upgrade to Windows 11. I'm going to recommend that you do so if you can, but that's all it is, my recommendation. As I've said in multiple places and multiple times, Windows 10 will keep working well beyond its end of support date. You can continue to use Windows 10 safely by taking more responsibility for your security. Eventually, though not immediately, some of your third-party applications may also end their support for Windows 10. If you don't want to, or you can't upgrade to Windows 11, keep calm and carry on in Windows 10. Now, Windows 11, coming up on 4 years old, it's a fine version of Windows. I've been using it daily since the day it was released, and I've been happy with it from the start. I have it on both my primary desktop machine and my laptop. Honestly, it feels to me more like a big feature update to Windows 10 than a completely different version of Windows. The taskbar was moved and there's a somewhat different look and feel to it, but there's pretty much the same operating system under the hood. Now, I know that not everyone feels this way, but from my perspective, there just wasn't that much to get used to when I switched. It and I just kept on working. Until now, though, my take was that Windows 11 rated a big eh. There just wasn't a compelling reason to switch. However, since Windows 10's end of support is getting closer, I do think it's time to start to consider the change, of course, as long as your hardware supports it. Yeah, one of the frustrating aspects of Windows 11 is the new system requirements. Many machines, even some newer ones, fail the compatibility test. There are workarounds for installing Windows 11 if your machine isn't up to the requirements. Microsoft has disabled many of the previous workarounds, and it's possible that those mentioned in the article will be disabled as well. However, Microsoft has also indicated that machines updated to Windows 11 bypassing the hardware requirements may not receive updates or may have other issues Microsoft won't address. Naturally, new machines are very likely to have Windows 11 pre-installed. Keep it. It's fine. There's definitely no reason to run away from Windows 11. As I said, I use it every day, and to me, it's just as fine as Windows 10. Now, I have to mention what we refer to as the every other version curse. This is not a reason to avoid Windows 11, but I find it interesting / entertaining. It goes like this. Windows XP was very popular. Windows Vista, not so much. Windows 7, again, very popular. Windows 8 and 8.1, again, not so much. Windows 10, on over a billion machines, it is still very, very popular. Windows 11, to be seen. It's as much superstition as anything else, and by itself, it is not a reason to avoid anything, particularly since there's been no word at all about any successor to Windows 11. And yet, seems like there's a pattern. Make of it what you will. But what about? To say that Windows 11 elicits strong opinions in some people is perhaps an understatement. I want to address some of the more common opinions. Quote, everyone hates Windows 11. No. Just no. In fact, a lot of people like it. Here's the thing. You're only likely to hear from those experiencing issues. They're looking for help, or they just want to vent in various public forums. The people who like it, the people for whom it's working just fine, are just quietly getting on with their work. I'm convinced that there are many, many more of them than there are haters. Microsoft is evil / spying / scanning / etc. That's not a Windows 11 problem. I know some feel Windows 11 is somehow worse in some Microsoft is evil kind of way, but I don't see it. Windows 10 introduced many of the telemetry things people complain about. To the best of my knowledge, Windows 11 hasn't really made anything significantly worse. Windows 11 pushes things on me that I don't want. That's not a Windows 11 problem either. Seriously, every version of Windows included features and functionality that many, though again, not all, people objected to. Sometimes people grew to like the feature, and sometimes the features just quietly disappeared. In addition, many of the current complaints aren't about Windows 11 per se, but about specific features being introduced and pushed hard across both Windows 10 and Windows 11. It's Microsoft pushing the features that's worthy of your ire. For example, OneDrive. Microsoft is colluding with hardware manufacturers to force us to buy new machines. Oh, hell no. Honestly, this conspiracy theory frustrates me to no end. No one is forcing you to purchase a new machine. Stick with Windows 10. Switch to Linux. Use one of the other hardware requirement bypasses. None of those options require you to spend a dollar. And yes, eventually you're likely to get a new machine, but not because anyone forces you to, but because it's time. That's been the case since PCs were invented. As a side effect, you'll then have a machine that meets the new hardware requirements. Quote, you're just a Microsoft shill. I often get accused of being on Microsoft's payroll. For the record, I haven't been for decades. Or getting paid to endorse them. And again, for the record, I have yet to see a single check. Or of some other kind of Microsoft apologist. When I recommend something like Windows 11, it triggers the anti-Microsoft crowd something fierce. I'm a pragmatic realist. I have lots of complaints about Microsoft and Windows. Lots. But I also realize that leaving Microsoft and leaving Windows behind isn't in the cards for many people, including most of my audience. Railing against all of Microsoft's evils, of which I agree there are many, wouldn't be helpful. Helping people switch to something else would benefit only a small portion of my audience. Instead, I try to help people make informed decisions and work within the system they have. So, bottom line, think about moving to Windows 11. If your machine can run Windows 11, and the PC Health Check app will tell you, then it's time to consider what you'll do next. You'll probably want to decide soon. Your options are upgrade to Windows 11 now and start getting used to it. Revert to Windows 10 if you can't stand it or have other issues. Wait. Upgrade to Windows 11 when the time gets closer. Wait, upgrade to Windows 11 when you get a new machine that comes with it pre-installed. Stay with Windows 10, or use this as an excuse to switch to Linux. Whatever your choice, make sure you take a complete system image backup prior to changing anything so that you can revert to what you have now if something doesn't work out. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/135037. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.